I have never felt the isolation that I do with terminal cancer. And the expression alone in a crowd is just, I think about it so often. I am surrounded. I honestly could not have better support. I'm very, very lucky that I have two parents who lean in instead of pull away. I have brothers who care about my legacy, who are always offering help in any way. I have a husband who is Superman. I don't know how I did that. And then I have best friends of decades long who are just doing everything they can to help. And none of them will ever, I hope none of them ever understand what this isolation is. It's not going 1 second without being fearful. It's about constant pain. It's about always wondering what that new feeling is, what that twitch was, what that pressure was. It's scanxiety, where you have scans every 2 to 3 months and you are just petrified to hear the results. It's isolation that no matter how many textbooks a doctor reads, no matter how many patients the doctor sees, he or she will never understand what that feeling of just nobody getting it. And that's why connection is just so essential, because you go from living your day-to-day in your life to meeting another young adult who might have a different cancer, might be a different age, might be another gender, might be totally different background, have nobody in their corner, and they still get it. There's an aspect of it. You might disagree on many things about treatment or about language around cancer, but that feeling of isolation is certainly met when you meet another young cancer patient who isn't twice your age, or who doesn't look at your mother and ask if she's the reason why you're getting a mastectomy bra, or walking into a group of in-person support group and just making assumptions that you're there for your grandmother or whatever it is. The isolation and the experience over and over again that other people don't know what this is like. And sometimes the things that people say, like the amount of times I'm told just stay positive, which I think you don't have cancer. Do you have that pressure to stay positive? Like, why do I, who's dying in my 30s, why do I have to be positive? That's kind of confusing. And I am a very positive person. So the other side of it is, yeah, I am positive. Like, do you feel like you're giving me some piece of knowledge that I hadn't considered before?